You're watching WFTDA.TV.
What's a new girl's name?
Low Tide.
Low Tide.
Wait for it.
Notorious Gear Deodorant. It can take it if you can.
Is that a jammer that just went by or a dumpster?
Dumpster!
Notorious Sports Gear Deodorant.
Because you stink!
Hi, I'm Anna Spankin and Trish the Dish here to tell you about Sin City Skates. Sin City Skates began in our living room in 2005 and has since grown into this 2,000 square foot warehouse and showroom where we stock everything for derby. If it's derby-related, we probably have it. Need help? With a combined on-track derby experience of over 24 years and still playing, we test everything we sell and we know the difference between facts and our opinions. We're always happy to share both with you to help you make the right decisions. So call us, SinCitySkates.com.
Good evening, my name is Plastic Patrick. I am here with Captain Lou Albamo. You are watching the 2014 Division II playoffs from Kitchener, Waterloo, Ontario. Yes, that's in Canada. Brought to you by the Tri-City Roller Derby and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association.
Today we are going to see the Queen City Roller Girls Lake Effect Furies take on Demolition City Roller Derby's Dynamite Dolls. Queen City comes from Buffalo, New York, mm-hmm. and are currently ranked 46th internationally in the WFPDA rankings. And Demolition City comes from Evansville, Indiana. They are ranked 60th, both teams in Division II. We should talk about some rosters now, Patrick.
Absolutely. Ranked 46th, seed number 2 at this playoff is Queen City from Buffalo. And they are number 153, Low Hits Griffin, 1666, Incinerator, 198, Black Rock Bruiser, number 21, Bikini Wax, number 240, Ivana Lay Her Out, 252, Miss Fire, 46, Midnight Maniac, The Captain, number 52, Tabrina Schreier, 54 is Head Huntress, 60, Pepper Sticks, 622, Librolian, 711 is Day Trip Her, 82, Tuesday Hula, and 99, Abercrombie and Fists. Now, what about Demolition City?
Demolition City's Dynamite Dolls will be wearing white today, kind of a grayish white. And they have brought number 0, Hertz Donut, 00, B-Donk-a-Donk, 21, Coco Cremaho, 22, Bangs McCoy, 25, Lickety Splint, 44, Steel Stitches, 51, Sprintin' Tarantino, 71, I'm a Hole Killer, 75, The Captain, Shelby in Pain, 777, Lala Oopsie, 81, Steffery, 82, Godzilla, 911, 4 Alarm, Felon, LB2X, Kinney Shot, and the Alts are 3X Terra Sunder, and No Hate, Flexibel.
Our officials for this bout will be head referee Jean-Philippe Aman, inside pack ref Jules on Regulations, jammer refs Professor Murder and Jim Schmidt, outside pack refs Number Cruncher, Freddie Mercenary, and Parking Lot, and our referee liaison is Cleveland.
And as always, if you wish to talk to your announcers, talk to WFTDA, that is the hashtag, talk to the number 2 WFTDA on the Twitters. You can also use hashtag WFTDA playoffs or hashtag KW awesome. Throw them all in there for added bonus points. You'll get hashtag fever on the Twitterverse. Patrick, we are going to have the matchup between the 2 and the 8 seeds in this game. We're about to get action underway. Once again, Demolition City in the white, Queen City in the black on the Fast Girl Skate. Gemmeline will be number 622, Librolian for the Lake Effect Furies. And Sprint and Tarantino, number 51 for the Dynamite Dolls.
And we are seconds away. What's on the line here is a spot in the fifth and sixth bout. That will be the winner. And the game is on. Have a good game, Derby World. Right away, Librolian makes a break for it. She's the lead jammer for Queen City. Queen City in the black. Demolition City in the white. She's already entered the pack. She's scoring. Out is Sprintin Tarantino. But Librolian has picked up four and calls it right off. Classic 4-0 quick jam.
Librolian was a top scorer for Queen City in their loss to Gold Coast yesterday. They lost 214 to 167. She managed to put up 60 points in that game. Queen City with a 4-0 lead. First jam in 29 minutes and 20 seconds remaining in the first half. And on the Fast Girl Skates, jammer line is going to be number 82 for Demolition City. That is Godzilla. And 153 in black for the Lake Effect Furies in Queen City is Low Hits Griffin.
And here we go. Boat jammers hit the pack. Of course, pack moving very slowly. At the front, we have Demolition City and Low Hits Griffin. At the back is Godzilla with the Queen City wall. Oh, she is pushed outside. And number 46, a Midnight Maniac, backs way up. At the front, here's 153, Low Hits Griffin pushing at the front. One more to beat. That seems to be 81. Steffery, a definitely key member of her team. But she is sent to the notorious RD penalty box. And Low Hits Griffin is lead jammer.
Yeah, Steffery doing double duty for Demolition City.
Oh, yeah.
Both jamming and blocking. They can't afford to lose her early on in this game.
Godzilla still working on the initial pass. Low Hits Griffin recycled behind by number 75. Shelby in pain. She's the captain, but she gets in front of her, no problem. Picks up 5 points, a grand slam for Low Hits Griffin. Brings Queen City to 9 points. Demolition City. Godzilla still working on the initial pass. And I'm afraid, no, she's still in track. Low Hits Griffin still working on that scoring run, her second scoring run. Godzilla finally breaks free. She's going to stop the bleeding. Low Hits Griffin working on some more points. She can probably afford to call it off now, which is exactly what she does. She had already picked up the four and brings Queen City to 13. Demolition City 0. 27:30 left in the half.
Midnight Maniac and Day Tripper from the Queen City Roller Girls Lake Effect Furies both picking up failure to reforms on that last jam. It's going to be a 4-on-2 pack advantage for Demolition City. That does bode well for Hertz Donut, who has had 111 points in this tournament so far for Demolition City. She's up against number 99. That's Abercrombie and Fists.
And look at that. Hertz Donut was looking for Demolition City's first lead jammer call. She gets it in a big way. She's only got two blockers to face, as the other two are in the penalty box. First scoring run is a problem, though. She's recycled at the back in a big hit. Abercrombie and Fist still working on the initial pass. Number 25, Lickety Splint, making it very difficult on her. She is recycled way back. In the meantime, Hertz Donut picks up 5, puts her team on the board at 5 points. Queen City 13.
Oh, wow.
Oh, yes. Wow. That looked like it hurt. In the meantime, however, Abercrombie and Fist completes her initial pass. Hertz Donut goes back for more. It's her second scoring run. Abercrombie and Fist is quick to enter the pack. And Hertz Donut is lead jammer, but she keeps it going. Abercrombie pushing at the front again. Licker and Splint, Lickety Splint. She escapes the pack, scores 5. And finally, Hertz Donut calls off the jam.
Yeah, 3 more points for Demolition City. That rolls them up to 8 in that jam, an 8-4 jam. At the end, big hits being laid out on the track. Headhunters getting a piece of Hertz Donut, and then an absolute pancake on the far side of one of the Queen City blockers as well. Back on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, 622 Librolian up against 51 Sprintin Tarantino.
First jam for both these skaters, and right away Librolian finds a hole and picks up lead jammer status. Sprintin Tarantino also out of the pack. She's about a half track behind. Pack moving very quickly, but Queen City know that their jammer is coming and stop the pack at a dead Speed and Librali, and right away finds a space and picks up. Let's see, we're waiting 1 point. Well, 1 point, better than nothing.
Just a single, that makes a score 18-8, a 10-point differential, 25 minutes remaining in the first half. Again, Librarian needs to roll very well for Queen City to take the win in this one. She ran into a lot of penalty trouble playing against Gold Coast in the second half, had four trips to the penalty box. She needs to skate clean. She's doing well so far. It is Incinerator for Queen City and Godzilla for Demolition City.
Incinerator's first jam, Godzilla second jam. Incinerator pushed out, recycled, but did she get a track cut? Nope. Yep, yes. Incinerator picks up a track cut at the back there, so she's going to sit in the notorious RED penalty box. That is the first power jam of the bout, and it belongs to Godzilla.
Godzilla with 87 points over the first two games in this tournament for Demolition City. She gets five more points there, Patrick.
That's right, and I'm sure there's plenty more coming. She's entering the pack right now. Queen City playing at full force, though, so four pack for both teams. And they recycle her way, way back. 7-11. That's day trip her has gone way back, and she calls it off. No points in this pass, protecting the points really well.
Yeah, and you know, that was Tabrina Schreier out there, number 52 for Lake Effect Fury. She is a pivotal member of the Queen City defense. She was plus 43 over 31 Ooh. Jams against Gold Coast, a game that Queen City lost, still coming out plus 43, an amazing stat for a blocker with that many jams in that game.
Well, it's no wonder she's the captain.
On the Fast Girl Skate Jammer line is Hertz Donut number 04, Demolition City still in the penalty box, Incinerator for Queen City.
That's right. Incinerator pushing at the front. She's facing a four wall of Queen City. Of course, Demolition City is sitting back, wanting that pack to stretch out, but Incinerator is back in play. And here we go, both jammers now fighting the respective walls. At the front, Hertz Donut, nobody's picked up lead jammer yet. Incinerator makes a break for it, and she picks up lead jammer status. She came from the penalty box. She had about 10 seconds to sit in the penalty box before she was released, but she managed to pick lead jammer. Hertz Donut still working on that initial pass. Difficult, tough wall from Demolition City.
And a track cut being called on Hertz Donut. She is now going to go to the notorious RED penalty box. And lead jammer is still with Incinerator. Power jam, Patrick.
Absolutely. Hertz Donut was at the very opposite end of the track, so she had to skate all the way around before her 30 seconds begin. Now she's in the box. Incinerator has already scored 5 points before Hertz Donut had actually sat down. Precious seconds. Now she's in for another scoring run. Here she goes, zooming, zigzagging around everyone. Oh, way low. She was on the ground, but that still counts. She calls off the jam after picking up 4. One pass didn't count.
So 14 points for Incinerator on that jam. It turned into a power jam, but she was already scoring before that power jam started. She calls it off, freezing Hertz Donuts in the notorious RED penalty box. Incinerator with 29 points in their first game. So 14 points, she's pretty much halfway there to her total from the first game. 5 seconds indicated. It's going to be low hits. Griffin, number 153 for Queen City on this power start.
Hertz Donut still in the notorious RED penalty box. Low hits. Griffin pushing at the front. She's facing a tough four wall of Demolition City. Now they start to bridge. She's still pushing, pushing. Great, great triangle formation. She's pushed back, and she's one more to go. Here we go. Number 21, excellent, Coco Cremaho. And Hertz Donut makes a break for it. She picks up lead jammer status just out of the penalty box. And now low hits Griffin. She exits the box. She exits the pack too. Hertz Donut's about to score. She hits a wall, falls to her knees, and calls off the jam. Did she pick up? She picked up one.
Just a single. That was Pepper Sticks who provided that little pop back that knocked Hertz Donuts off her skates, preventing any additional points from being scored. Demolition City now at 14 points. Queen City at 32. 20 minutes and 28 seconds remaining in the first half. Rydell Skates, unmatched quality, unmatched performance. Check them out at rydellskates.com. And on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line is number 622 for Queen City and 51 Sprint Tarantino Quick. Road Demolition City. 622 Librarian, in case I forgot to mention that.
Absolutely. Before I even had to say, I had a chance to say it, she was lead jammer. She made a quick break for the inside line, picked up lead jammer status. So quickly, she's already back into the pack. Scores of 4 points. Britton Tarantino exited the pack as well, though. So Librarian called it right off. Queen sitting at 36. Demolition City 14. 19:44 left in the half.
Yeah, and we mentioned Librarian really needs to skate well for Queen City. They want to move on to that 5-6 game. Someone that Dynamite Dolls have to focus on. We're going to get an official time out. Librarian is 3-for-3 on lead jammer statuses so far in this game. That does bode well, although Queen City did have a tough second half, so the Dynamite Dolls should not despair. They are only down by 22 points.
Yeah.
And that is, if Queen City has as bad a second half as they did yesterday, that is easily made up against them.
Well, if, you know, this weekend is anything to go by, this difference is nothing.
No, there is no safe lead.
No.
Roller Bones and Bones Bearings make for a winning combination. You can see them at rollerbones.com. With the 5-second signal, we're going to get number 99. That is Abercrombie and Fist and Godzilla on the line. That's 82.
Queen City in the black, Demolition City in the white. Abercrombie pushing at the front against a three wall. Same thing for Godzilla. Both teams playing minus one blocker. No, one blocker comes in to help. Lend a hand for Demolition City. She provides the O, but does not help because Abercrombie is already broken out of the pack. She's lead jammer status. Godzilla still working on that initial. Though blockers from Queen City just keep coming at the front. Abercrombie already scoring. Godzilla still working on the initial, and now she's out. Abercrombie is probably going to make a break for it. She's probably got a number of points now, but no, she picks up a track cut, which she does not agree with, but that doesn't matter.
It does not matter. She will sit for 30 seconds in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box, and it is now Godzilla with the power jam.
Godzilla still has to perform the initial pass. Now, the pack has proven very tough, but just as I say that, of course, she breaks free from the pack and is now eligible to score. Lead jammer status has already been assigned to Abercrombie when she's in the box, so this will go the full 2 minutes. Godzilla is pushed out, doing an excellent job at that penalty kill. Demolition City contempt with sitting in the back. Now they have to contempt with an extra blocker, which they dealt with very easily, just pushing her to the outside. Again, Godzilla recycled way, way back. The jammer for Queen City, Abercrombie, is back in the track. And she is about to pick up some points. She picks up 5. Godzilla is also out of the pack, picks up 4. This jam is 10 seconds away from being called off by the refs. Both jammers entering the pack hot, and they will pick up some more points. Abercrombie picks up 4 more. Godzilla picks up 3.
So yeah, more scoring from both sides in that jam. Queen City at 44, Demolition City at 27. 8 points scored by Queen City, 13 by the Dynamite Dolls. Creep a little bit closer, but very tough defense by Queen City, limiting the damage. Number 00, that's Badonkadonk, taking the star for the first time in this game, and it is 1666 Incinerator once again for Queen City.
And the jam is off. Incinerator pushing at the front. The defense for Demolition City proving to be very strong, but not strong enough to hold back Incinerator. She's got one more to beat, and she breaks free. Lead jammer Incinerator. Badonkadonk still dealing with, I think, the story so far of this bout is the Queen City defense.
Yeah, the Queen City defense has really been locking down jammers. They have to be careful with the penalties they've picked up, but doing a great job of containing Dynamite Doll jammers.
Yeah, Incinerator on a scoring run, but Badonkadonk has now exited the pack, so she will probably limit the damage to one scoring run. She does have to exit the pack, though. Well, no, she doesn't. She's probably picked up a number of points now. But here comes Badonkadonk, so Incinerator calls it off after picking up 4.
That moves Queen City to 48. Demolition City remains at 27, 16 minutes remaining in the first half of this game 11 of the tournament, game 5 of the day. Winner goes on to play for 5th place. Loser goes on to play for 7th place. On the Fast Girl Skates Gemmerline is the Librarian number 622 for Queen City and Sprint and Tarantino number 51 for the Demolition. Roller Derby.
Queen City in the black, Demolition City in the white. And at the front, Librarian makes a break for it. Oh, what great skating style. She zoomed around everybody. I think she's got a speed skating background with that fantastic stride. She is your lead jammer.
Well, look Woo-hoo-hoo! Out. Monster apex jump. She cleared it with feet to spare, and it was huge.
Well, they were right there at that sweet spot. Sprint and Tarantino. Essex the pack, but Librarian already in a scoring position. She is going to call it off as she sees Sprint and Tarantino. No points awarded on this pass.
But the 5 points from the Librarian came while she was airborne. Great distance by the athletic acrobatic skater from Queen City. Not only can she get great distance, but I have seen her clear 4 or 5 feet in the air on her skates in height. She gets big height as well. We'll see if she gets acrobatics later in the game. Low hits Griffin for Queen City and steel stitches for the first time in this game for Demolition City.
Queen City playing minus 2 blockers on this one. This might make a difference. At the front, steel stitches. Indeed it does. It picks up lead jammer status. And low hits Griffin picks up a penalty, a track cut penalty. She will be sitting in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box along with the captain,
Sabrina Schreier,
both in the box. This will make it very easy for Steel Stitches to rack up the points. She's got 2 blockers to contend with, but no big deal. She didn't even stop. She picks up 5, a grand slam for Demolition City. Brings their total 37, Queen City at 53.
The headhunters wanted a track cut, but her skate did not touch down out of bounds. Continues skating. She's back into pack Patrick and looking for more points.
And points she gets. No, a last minute push out. Yes, number 240. Ivana Lejerout is going to go sit in the penalty box for that hit. 5 points were awarded to the Demolition City jammer.
And just as we said, Queen City was looking good in this game. Demolition City comes roaring back.
Oh, yeah.
We're just looking for a last bit of confirmation on the scoring. It currently is 53-42 in favor of Queen City. 15 points for the Dynamite Dolls. You can talk to us on the Twitters at #talk2WFTDA. Make sure you make your comments to the Twitterverse. We love to read them. On the Fast Girl Skates, Jammer Line is 0, Hertz Donuts, and 252, Misfire for Queen City.
Oof, Misfire gets a hit. She falls to the ground on the outside of the track. Hertz Donut is pushed to the inside. Another break for it, Misfire, and she falls again. And both jammers going to the penalty box. Hertz Donut is going, I'm waiting for the signal, a track cut.
Yep.
And a track cut as well for Miss Fire. So they will both sit for about 5 seconds. No jammer, no play. And the pack is going in reverse. Queen City at the back, Demolition City at the front. Both jammers need to perform their initial pass, and nobody is going to claim lead jammer status. There's 1:15 left in this jam, and we're going to go all the way.
Bikini Wax picking up a failure to reform. Oof. She goes to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box. Not a lot of blockers on the track for Queen City at the moment.
No, which is why Hertz Donut clears the back on her initial. And a Misfire pushed to the outside again. She's on the ground. She gets up, and now she's contending with the last line of defense. Bidonka Donk. She clears the pack on her initial, but Misfire is already... No, I'm sorry, that's Hertz Donut is already scoring. She picks up 4. Misfire is about to catch up to the pack. 4 blockers for Demolition City, 3 for Queen City. Misfire hits the pack. Hertz Donut hits the pack. Both packs at full force now, making it difficult for both jammers to pick up any points. And a big spill for Misfire. And the Demolition City, oh, Lord. She was pushed to the outside, and she'll be recycled by Steffery.
Looks like a skate problem for Misfire on the outside. I don't think she can continue on in this jam. She can't seem to keep get back on her feet. I don't think it's an injury. I think it's technical.
Nope.
And Hertz Donut skating off. Jam gets called off.
The jam was up.
I think we're going to need a skate tech for Misfire.
Hmm.
Unfortunate for the Queen City Jammer. 56-51 is the score now. 9-3. We're going to get an official timeout on that, Patrick. Again, you are watching WFTDA.TV's International 2014 WFTDA D2 Playoffs from Kitchener, Waterloo, Ontario, Canada, which is where we are.
Canada.
And this is, of course, the Queen City Roller Girls Lake Effect Furies against the Demolition City Roller Derby Dynamite Dolls. A little bit of chaos at the end of that jam. Patrick, there has been some penalty trouble already in this game. Ivana Layer out, and Queen City is already at 4. And Steffery, that key blocker.
Yeah. Key blocker slash key jammer.
Slash jammer.
Yep.
Backup jammer for Dynamite Dolls. Also at 4 trips to the notorious RED penalty box. So both of those skaters are going to have to be careful as the game proceeds. We still have 10 minutes and 46 seconds remaining in the first half of this game. Now, the Demolition City Dynamite Dolls lost to Bear City on the final jam of the game on day one. That meant that they had to play Boulder County to get to this game. They beat Boulder County. And that is why they are here with an opportunity to play for fifth place overall. Again, Queen City's in black. Dynamite Dolls from Demolition City are in white. And the score currently 56-51 in the favor of the Lake Effect Furies. And we are just going to get a bit of a clarification from Cleveland. There was an official timeout, not an official review. It was just called by the referees.
Yeah,
and we're just getting some clarification from Cleveland, our announcer ref, as to what happened and what was the reason for that official timeout.
And I have a feeling it was a reason a little deeper than a skate malfunction.
So Double H is putting her headphones back on, switching on the mic, and Double H.
Just trying to clarify that. We had two penalty box violations.
Oh.
One from our white jammer that is currently in the box, that is Hertz Donut. And then from another black skater that we're still trying to get clarification on which one it is, because we do have two in the box right now. But, of course, that means an additional penalty for both of these skaters to serve.
Yeah, it's Pepper Sticks and Bikini Wax in the notorious RD penalty box as blockers for the Lake Effect Furies. I'm seeing Bikini Wax picking up a misconduct penalty, so I'm going to assume that it was her that
That's
picked up that
the
second
one.
Penalty.
Yeah, so skaters are required to enter the penalty box in full control and not crash into the chairs, otherwise they are assigned an extra penalty box trip.
This is true. We should also remind you that Radar Presto is a proud partner of the WFTDA broadcast that you are listening to right now. RadarWheels.com is where you can find out information about those wheels. We're about to get the game back underway. 2-on-3 pack advantage for Demolition, but they don't have a jammer. It's Librolian on a power jam.
Yeah, they send Librolian, and that's who I would go to as well. She's recycled at the back, but I'm guessing that, no, she didn't actually exit the track. It looked like she did from here, but she did not. She picked up lead jammer status. She can now score. Now let's see. Of course, the Queen City blockers are bringing the pack to a crawl. Big wall of Demolition City at the front. The pack is broken, and Librolian does what she does best and weaves her way around all of these blockers.
Oh, a forearm penalty.
Yep.
As she tried to get around Steffery, she's going to the notorious RD penalty box. We've got a star pass going to Shelby in pain as Hertz Donuts came out of the penalty box. Jam's underway again. We're going to full 2 minutes. Now Demolition City on the power jam.
Yeah, Shelby in pain, wasting some precious seconds there at the back, putting on the star. You do not have to wear the star to perform the initial pass. However, she performed the initial pass nonetheless, and now she will be scoring. She enters the pack. She's pushed to the inside. And, of course, they're going to bring it back. There is Tabrina Schreier recycling. So much so that she is sent to the penalty box.
Yeah, she picked up a track cut. She went back in the correctly.
Number 75, Shelby in pain, is your jammer for Demolition City. She is entering the pack again on another scoring run. And she is contending with Pepper Sticks at the front of the pack. picks up four this time. Librarian back into play. She's awarded her grand slam. Shelby in pain, entering the pack at the very back. It didn't look good on her. There was no organization for the Queen City defense. She just exited the pack like she entered. 4 points on her. Librarian having a tougher time than before. Oh, her old friend Steffery is there to greet her. And Steffery again at the front of the pack. She picked up zero. And now Queen City at 61. Demolition City takes the lead at 64 with 8 minutes 30 left in the half.
They do indeed. And you know, every single skater that was on the track for Queen City picked up a penalty during that jam.
Whew.
Not surprising that that ended up flipping the score 64 to 61 now in favor of the team from Evansville, Indiana, Demolition City. Going to the line, 82, that's Godzilla against Incinerator, 1666 for Queen City.
Godzilla catching her stride from way, way back on the track, but it didn't serve her well because Incinerator picks up lead jammer status. Incinerator must have a pretty good record this game.
Oh, Godzilla. Very well.
Godzilla exits the pack as well. Incinerator, oof, big hit on her. She stays on the track. One blocker from Queen City in Notorious R.E.D. penalty box. Godzilla enters the pack. She is pushed to the outside by Pepper Sticks.
She
still picks up two, and so does Incinerator.
Yeah, Incinerator, a little bit of a late call-off. Incinerator is batting 75% as lead jammer. She's got 20 points. She is the lead scorer for Queen City now with those 20 points. But, yeah, that late call-off. Giving up 2 points to Godzilla. Now on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line is going to be number 99, Abercrombie and Fist against 51. That's Sprint and Tarantino from Demolition City.
Queen City in the black, Demolition in the white. Sprint and Tarantino picks up her first lead jammer call of the bout. And Abercrombie is recycled to the back. Sprint and Tarantino entering the pack. Abercrombie still working on the initial. But she is pushed to the outside. That's Sprint and Tarantino. Abercrombie exits the pack. Sprint and Tarantino still working on those points. Big wall of black at the back. And she does not call off the jam. Instead, she exits and picks up 4 points.
Yeah, those are the first 4 points for Sprint and Tarantino in this game. But she has had 86 over the previous two games she played in this tournament.
Abercrombie recycled by Steffery again. Key blocker for Demolition City. Sprinton enters the pack again, calls it off, picks up two more, and Abercrombie picks up three.
Headhunter's picking up a direction of gameplay during that jam. That is her third trip to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box. Peppersticks has four. Ivana Layer out has four. Bikini Wax has three. Schreier has three. Penalty trouble on the Lake Effect Fury side. We're going to get another jam underway with 6 minutes remaining in the game. 72-66 for Demolition City. Steel Stitch is 44 against No Hits Griffin, 153.
And the pack moving right through turn three. Steel Stitches is your lead jammer for Demolition City. And Low Hits Griffin is sent to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box on a track cut. That is a power jam for Steel Stitches, 44.
Second trip for Low Hits Griffin. Steel Stitches with 15 points the last time she had the star.
And this adds five. A grand slam for Steel Stitches. Pack at a dead stop. All the blockers are on the track. Somebody comes into offense. And it seems to work, but she has not exited the pack yet. But she's right at the front, and number 240. Ivana lay her out as the last line of defense. She gets a no pass, no penalty because she pushed her out of the track. She's still working on that front wall. Now a big three fall. She decides she's had enough. She calls it off, but she still picked up the five.
Yeah, you know, day tripper number 711 from Lake Effect Furies came in full speed and just bounced off of Steel Stitches, crashed to the ground. Steel Stitches with 10 points, 25 points in this game, 66 to 82 as Demolition City continues to increase her lead. 4.5 minutes remaining in the first half. Printco Graphics for all your printing needs. Hit up printcographics.com. And on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, Godzilla and Librarian.
Librarian
Oh, a track Genishvi cut.
Genishvi picks up a track cut. Librolian, another one. Unfortunately for her, Godzilla picked up lead jammer status. It was available. Now a power jam for Demolition City. They are sitting at 82, Queen City at 66. And Godzilla on that power jam is looking to add to that. Her blockers coming in to help. The front wall of Queen City. Incredible. Incredible. Number 54, Headhuntress. The last line of defense, 82. Tuesday Hula comes in to help, and she is the one who makes the hit, pushes Godzilla out of the track, and she recycles very slowly. I think she's had a hard time in this jam. Those are no easy points. Again, that was Tabrina Schreier pushing Godzilla out, but she lands in the penalty box for that hit.
That's her fourth trip to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box. Power jam is over. Librolian back on the track.
That was her initial. Godzilla's had enough. She calls it off. She had picked up the 5 points.
So that was the seventh jammer penalty for Queen City in this half to the three that Demolition City had, all going to Hertz Donut, picking up that second penalty for the misconduct earlier. 87-66, Demolition City in black, Queen City in white. 3 minutes remaining in the first half of this game on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line is number 99, Abercrombie and Fist for Queen City, and number 51, Sprint Tarantino for Demolition City.
Pack is off. The jammers take a little bit of time. They want to work the element of surprise, and it works for Sprint and Tarantino as she picks up lead jammer status. Abercrombie still working on the defense. Three beautiful formation at the front. And now one more. That's Steffery again, that key blocker for Demolition City. Oh, big hit on her. Steffery. And then she just stands there staring her down. Ouch. Again, big hit from Steffery. And in the meantime, Sprint and Tarantino has come back in to score, but she is facing a wall of her own. Queen City at the back. Sprint and Tarantino again dealing with Steffery. And number 240, that's a final lay her out, takes care of Sprint and Tarantino. She decides, I've had enough.
Yeah.
And calls it off.
Abercrombie had enough. She was staring down Steffery. She was not pleased with a hit that she received, completely 100% legal, knocking her down to the ground. Did not want to re-engage with Steffery. Steffery sitting on 4 penalties so far in this half, but showing why Demolition City loves to have her on the track.
Oh, yeah.
92-66 is the score for Demolition City. 90 seconds remaining in this half. It's going to be Incinerator against Godzilla on the Fast Girl Skate Jammer line.
And here we go. Oh, and Godzilla picks up a penalty. That means Incinerator is going to go be on a power jam. That's a back block penalty for Godzilla. She's going to sit in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box, and so does Incinerator. Picks up a track cut. That means Godzilla is going to be brought back onto the track in about 10 seconds.
So also means it's going to be the last jam of this half as we'll run the full 2 minutes, Patrick.
Absolutely. Demolition City 92, Queen City, been a while since they've been sitting at 66. Oh, Incinerator, illegal re-entry. She had to enter at the back, and she did not see her own blockers. Illegal procedure. She has to go back to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box. She was at the opposite end, too. She has not sat down yet. This gives precious time for Godzilla to pick up points, but she has not been very successful at getting any points. Star pass now to number 75, Shelby and Payne, the captain. And she completes the initial pass. That, can you believe that was all for the initial pass? A whole minute and 20 seconds.
Yep. Crazy jam so far. Shelby Payne re-engaging. Direction of the gameplay is going to free up the pack a bit. No, that's
Godzilla.
Demolition City skater going.
Yeah. Godzilla Incinerator back in play. She completes her initial. Shelby in pain is still working in that scoring run. She probably has a few points of her own, but she can't call it off. There are no lead jammer. She picks up a track cut. Shelby in pain is going to the penalty box. Are they going to send her around? No. She's good for her. Incinerator now approaching the pack. She's got... Whoa, she's had 4 blockers to 3. So quick 5 points for Incinerator, which will bring Demolition City at 95, Queen City at 76. We are going to the half. friends and lovers.
And we're actually going to get, before halftime starts, an official review by Queen City at the end.
Their and coach, I know why.
Yeah, their coach Guillotine coming in. Patrick, why do you think Guillotine's out there?
Because the blocker, or the jammer, rather, Shelby in Pain, who was the jammer, entered the penalty box skating backwards, as you are supposed to skate in the counterclockwise way, the same way that we play. She went back to sit in the penalty box, and the coach was right next to her, and he saw it.
Oh, yes. He was not happy on the bench when he saw her being allowed to sit down in the notorious RED penalty box. You are correct. The question is, will a point of no return violation, the question will be if they make her restart her penalty or not. They're going to take a look before we get to halftime. Score is 95-76 for Demolition City at the half. That last jam was a 10-3 jam in favor of Queen City. Now, Queen City had 12 jammer penalties when they faced off against Gold Coast yesterday. They had 5 in the first half, 7 in the second half. So far, in the first half of this game, they've managed to pick up 9 jammer penalties. That's a lot of jammer penalties for
That's
one half.
That's a lot
passer.
Of jammer penalties, and it's, you know, unfortunately, the situation doesn't seem to be improving. Queen City, on the other hand, they're picking up a lot of jammer penalties, too.
But Dynamite, the Dynamite Dolls have 4. They have 4 trips to the box themselves. But Queen City are the, Queen City with 9 trips.
Yes,
in this
that's
half.
What I meant.
Right. The Dynamite Dolls, they've played 2 games so far. They had 12 jammer penalties in their first game. They had 8 jammer penalties in their second game. 4 in the first half. That's keeping their, 8 is still a fair number of jammer penalties.
Yeah.
But they're keeping it down. And looks like we're going to get some clarification momentarily. And Jean-Philippe Anand, the head referee of this crew from Montreal Roller Derby, Canadian head ref
Absolutely.
At the Canadian tournament.
Yeah, but you know what? Despite us having all this knowledge of what happened, means absolutely nothing because it's their call. And, thank God, because they're right there. They're overlooking the lines, and we may know all we want, but they have the final say.
That notorious RED penalty box has been getting a real workout. Notorious Gear Deodorant by Notorious RED. You can order it online at notoriousred.com. We will come back from the half with all sorts of stats, but Double H is going to give us clarification on that official review.
All this conjecture. We were conjecturing the exact wrong thing.
Of course.
So what happened was Queen City...
Oh, look at that.
Queen City challenged a no call on a stopped block from Godzilla. And that call, the no call, was actually overturned. So there is a call now. No. Godzilla will be starting in the penalty box for period 2.
Okay.
Well, look at that. And I'm an announcer, not a ref.
That's why you look so wonderful. So they'll get an extra blocker in the box.
Yep.
Queen City would have retained their official review, but it disappears at the half, so...
Well, it's done.
That's all they get. But yeah, Plastic Patrick, the score 95-76, Demolition City over Queen City. The battle to see who will get to go to play for 5th place or 7th place against DC or the Outfit.
Yep.
We're going to have 5. Another half.
Yep.
We'll be back in a while on WFDDA.tv.
Bring it in. Keep coming. Oh, time for an upgrade. Radar Presto.
Say, these are nice.
Stunning.
On you go. Yeah.
Wreckingville, St. Louis Gatekeepers,
Bellstar, Rose City Rollers,
Erkin Martin, Denver Roller Dolls,
Gimme Mission, Atlanta Roller Girls,
Meow Mix, Jacksonville Roller Girls,
Kiki Your Ass from Pike's Peak Derby Dames,
Shane Bauer, St. Louis Gatekeepers,
I trust,
I skate,
I am,
I am, Noah Derby.
This was definitely a proud moment for me, wearing the black, white, and red. It's such a bold uniform, first of all. It's just Texas right across. That's a team, you skate out onto that track, and there's just no guessing who you are. You just feel the team. It feels very much like the kind of thing you want to wear out into battle. And it's really great. I like it. I'm Fifi Nominon with the Texas Roller Girls Texecutioners, and S1 is part of my uniform.
Brenda Gold, and I've been at Rydell for 36 years almost. Everything is done by hand, basically. Just a one pair actually going through at a time then. And some of them are multiple colors where it'll have 5-6 colors, metallics, the different colored full grains, you name it. Some of them are pretty wild. To me, the skaters are really important because that's what keeps us going here. It's the consumer or the skater that decides, okay, is it good enough for me or not? We want them to be happy, that's for sure.
Are watching the 2014 Division II WFTDA playoffs live from Kitchener-Waterloo. We are in the middle of a bout. Queen City out of Buffalo at 76, a Demolition City out of Evansville, Indiana. My name is Plastic Patrick. Captain Lou Albamo.
Captain Lou Albamo, right here beside you once again, Patrick. Always
yes.
A pleasure.
Absolutely.
The Demolition City Queen City game, 95-76. Queen mm-hmm. City was leading this game up to the 13th jam of the first half, and then Demolition City took over.
Yeah.
Penalties, and more penalties.
Where have I heard that before?
Oh, I know. It seems to be the story every time with roller derby.
Yeah.
Jammer penalties, 9 trips to the box for Queen City. With that last penalty to Godzilla, they've got her listed as 6 trips to the penalty box, or 6 trips total. She's done 3. Now, I do not remember if she has gone as a jammer for the beginning of this half. I don't believe that she was a jammer when she picked that up, so I think it's only 5 jammer penalties according to the stats.
You mean this last one?
This
she
last
went as
one,
a blocker.
Yes. That's right. I think she just went as a blocker.
She had passed the star.
So I think it's 9-5 jammer penalties, but overall penalties, 30 penalties in the first half for Queen City. That is a lot of penalties.
Yeah.
And 16 for Demolition City. Now, in the first game that Queen City played against Gold Coast, they had 48 penalties. So they're already looking to eclipse that in this game.
That's not the kind of record you want to eclipse.
Not the kind of record you want. Demolition no. City had penalty trouble of their own in their first game against Bear City, 42 trips. In their win over Boulder County, 35 trips. So they can be penalty heavy as well, but they played fairly cleanly in this game, 16 penalty trips. People who are in penalty trouble, I Want to Lay You Out, Tabrina Schreier, and Pepper Sticks, all on 4. for Queen City. So they have really spread their penalties out, but those skaters are all in danger. Over on Demolition City side, Steffery has four trips to the Notorious RID penalty box.
Demolition City
cannot afford to lose her. She's been fantastic as a blocker in this game. We've seen her jam as well this weekend.
Many times.
But she has been a nightmare on the track for jammers of Queen City. So Demolition City does not want to lose her. Now, over on the scoring side of the story, top jammer is Incinerator with 30 points for Queen City. Over on Demolition side, it's Hertz Donut with 31 points. Steel Stitches is running at 100% jammer percentage for Demolition City. She's been out there twice.
Right.
She's put 25 points up. Great clutch alt jamming on the part of Steel Stitches. And the lead jammer percentage for Queen City is Librarian. She's only been able to jam six times. They're running five jammers out there. 67% lead jammer percentage. Dynamite Doll sending six. Six jammers to the line. Badonkadonk, Godzilla, Hertz Donut, Shelby and Payne, Sprint and Tarantino, and Steel Stitches. All of them have picked up points except for Badonkadonk. She had a little trouble when she was out there, but that's all right. She only had 4 points scored against her. We're going to get the second half underway, Patrick. Demolition City, Queen City. They want to play for fifth place. And it is going to be a power jam for number 622, Librarian. Queen City in the black, Demolition City in the white.
Yeah, Shelby and Payne, the jammer for Demolition City is in the Notorious RID penalty box. Librarian makes quick work of that pack. She picks up lead jammer status. She has four blockers to help her out, three blockers on the track for Demolition City. She's already entered the pack on a scoring run. Here she is. Here she goes. Oh, with Steffery again in the front of that pack. What a nightmare that woman has been for the opposite team. She picks up five, however. Jammer for Demolition City. Shelby and Payne is back in the pack. She's sent to the inside. She does have to perform her initial pass, however. Librarian is back into the pack. She's scoring. She's working on another five-point pass. And Steffery versus Librarian. These two will actually go to dinner, I predict. She picks up five. That's 10 points so far for Librarian.
Now, Steffery picked up her fifth penalty, Patrick, in that blocking.
Oh, boy. Shelby and Payne didn't get a chance to score. Librarian picked up 10 in this. And this jam brings Demolition City to 95 and Queen City inching back at 86.
An illegal procedure at the end of that jam. The headhunter sends her to the Notorious RED penalty box. That will leave us with a 3-on-3 pack. Again, 95-86, Queen City losing at the moment to Demolition City. 28 and a half minutes remaining in this game. Number 99 is Abercrombie and Fist. Number 51 is Sprint and Tarantino.
And both teams playing minus their pivots, as they're both in the Notorious RED penalty box. Queen City in the black, Demolition City in the white. At the front, that is Abercrombie and Fist picking up lead jammer status. She makes a break for it. Sprint and Tarantino still working on the initial pass. There's one more blocker to face, and she has cleared the pack. Abercrombie's already scoring. She makes quick work on the inside line, calls it right off, picks up four. Queen City 86, Demolition City fights back at 95.
So Queen City fans have to be pretty pleased with the way that the score has been rolling in the second half, 95-90 for Demolition City, but a 14-0 run to start this half. Queen City gave up a 104-9 run against Gold Coast in their game in the second half. We're going to get Steel Stitches, number 44, going up against 1666 Incinerator on the Fast Girl Skates Jammer Lion.
And Demolition City playing minus two blockers makes very easy for Incinerator to pick up lead jammer status. Steel Stitches recycled at the very back by 7-11. Day trip her. She is not re-entered yet. And in the meantime, Incinerator picked up a grand slam. Day trip her again. Causes the track. Does she cause the track cut?
Yes, she does.
She pulls the track cut on Steel Stitches. That means Incinerator is going to go out again. She's got 10 points. That's a power jam for Queen City. Here she, going around the two blockers at the back of the pack. She's in the front. She makes quick work of the pack. Five more points, 15 so far for Incinerate Her.
There was Day Tripper and Ivana Layer out who paired up with that track cut, Patrick. Hit by Day Tripper, the drawback by Ivana Layer out. Power Jam continues.
Incinerator pushing at the front. Queen City Blockers Contempt with sitting at the back. Whew. She was facing her. She's allowed to plow into her. And in the meantime, she picked up a forearm block. Incinerator will be sitting in the penalty box, as will Brangs McCoy. That will release Steel Stitches, Power Jam Dynamites, Demolition City. Demolition Dolls, here she is, the Steel Stitches pushing at the front. I think she has to perform her initial pass. And she does, mission accomplished. She can now score points, but there's only 25 seconds left in the jam. Incinerator standing up, that means a few seconds left in her penalty. Steel Stitches enters the pack. She continues to score. She's pushed to the inside. Incinerator back in play. She's scoring already. She's pushed to the outside by Steffery. Steffery wants to draw her back. And Steel Stitches heads to the penalty box on a track cut. She's sitting down right now as the jam ends. And this will allow Queen City to start on another power jam.
And not just that, Patrick, but with that jam, a 19-3 advantage for Queen City. They go from down 95-76 at the half to up 109-98 in the second half. 25 minutes remaining in this game. It is a power start for Queen City. They send 622 Librarian to the Fast Girl Skates Jammer line.
And I would too. Queen City in the black on a power jam. Demolition City in the white. Librarian has to contend with that front wall. One more blocker to beat. Of course, look at that. It's Steffery. Big surprise. Number 22, Bangs McCoy also. She lands in the box for that hit. Librarian picks up lead jammer status. Queen City at the back. Demolition City in the front. They send 54. Head Huntress to clear the way for her. Doesn't work out so well. Steffery still in there. But Librarian picks up five. Jammer Force Demolition City is back into play. That's number 44, Steel Stitches. She's pushed to the outside. And now a power jam for Steel Stitches and Demolition City. Librarian's heading to the notorious RD penalty box. High block on Steel Stitches. Are we working on how many jammer penalties we can get in one bout?
Well, perhaps.
Librarian is released after about 10 seconds, and so will Steel Stitches. Librarian re-enters the pack, big wall of white at the front. She's contending with them. She clears that pack, and she picks up five. Steel Stitches back in play. She's contending with the wall of black at the back, which is falling apart, but they still manage to hold her up. Librarian is back into the wall very quickly, and she is recycled. Recycled back by Steffery and her partner. Penalties being assessed again at the front. Steel Stitches. Nobody's passed the star yet. Librarian is working on a scoring run. The longest jam in history comes to an end.
That was madness. We have had three jammer penalties to Demolition City, two jammer penalties to Queen City in this half. 22 and a half minutes remaining. Queen City 124, 100 for Demolition City. The scoring was 15-12 in that jam. This tournament has been exciting, Patrick, and you can get your tournament merchandise at the WFTDA.com/store. Check it out online. Another jam underway.
Low hits Griffin for Queen City. Godzilla for Demolition City. At the front of the pack, it's Low Hits Griffin contending with one more blocker. And that was Badonkadonk. She makes quick work of that pack. She is your lead jammer. Godzilla now working the pack. She's got four blockers to contend with. Four blockers for Queen City. Badonkadonk heads to the penalty box. But Low Hits Griffin is already scoring. And here she is going for Mer. Godzilla has not yet performed her initial pass. They are drawing her way, way back. And that was a long engagement zone. Looking for that call. Number 81, Steffery, was pushing far too away from the engagement zone. She lands in the penalty box, but there's no room at the end. She has to continue scoring. And now, 153, Lohitz Griffin lands in the penalty box on the back block. It's a power jam for Godzilla. She has to complete her initial pass.
Godzilla doesn't want to engage anymore.
No.
She's done.
Steffery cannot pick up the star because she's the pivot, but she has to report to the penalty box. Godzilla is out there on her lonesome, and she cannot pass the star. She's going to try one more go at it.
There we go.
Yep. Not quite. 7-11. Day Tripper was trying to make her life hell again. Low hits Griffin. Now out of the penalty box, she's the jammer for Queen City. Godzilla, ooh, falls into the arms of her blocker. That's been a tough, tough jam for Godzilla. She's going to try one more go at it. In the meantime, Low hits Griffin, pushes at the front, two blockers to contend with. Multiple player block on
Shelby and Payne. That's
Shelby
her
and
sixth.
Grand slam picked up by Low hits Griffin. Wow.
Another.
Godzilla has never heard such sweet music as those four tweets.
Yeah, that another crazy jam. Shelby and Payne picking up her sixth trip to the Notorious R.O.D. penalty box. Steffery picking up her sixth trip to the Notorious R.O.D. penalty box. The penalties going all against the Dynamite Dolls in the second half. Not that the Lake Effect Furies aren't picking up their own penalties. We do have a timeout for Demolition City right now. Score is 134 to 102 in favor of Queen City. Queen City in black, Demolition City in white. But yeah, the penalties are just coming fast and furious in these long two-minute jams.
Yeah.
The jammers are taking penalties. It means that no one's able to call anything off again. Dynamite Dolls with 9 jammer penalties in this game. We have 12 jammer penalties for Queen City. Queen City, amazingly, has not got any skaters over 4 trips to the Notorious R.O.D. penalty box. They do have several skaters with 4. They have Incinerator, Ivana Layerout, Debrina Schreier, Headhuntress, Pepper Sticks. So potentially they could be in trouble as the game continues. And we'll see what happens when the game continues, because we get roller derby back in the way. Hertz Donuts, donut number 0, skating for Demolition City. It's number 99, Abercrombie and Fists for the Lake Effect Furies. Queen City in black, Demolition City in white.
Queen City 134, Demolition City 102. Here we go, kids. Hertz Donut recycled at the back. At the front, Abercrombie makes a push for it. Number 25, that's Lickety Splint, is the last line of defense. She gets sent to the penalty box on a blocking with the head. Hertz Donut is on a power jam. She has 32 points to make up to take the lead.
13th jammer penalty for Queen City with that high block, Patrick. Again, jammer penalties, jammer penalties, jammer penalties.
Yeah, absolutely. She's contending with the big wall of black at the back. And she makes a break for it on the outside. One more block is waiting for her. That's number 82, Tuesday Hula. She picks up 5 points. That's a grand slam for Hertz Donut. Demolition City now at 107. Power jam over. Abercrombie is back in play. She has to perform her initial pass, though. Hertz Donut picks up another scoring run. 4 points. That's 9 so far. Abercrombie contending with the pack. She's trying to perform her initial pass, but Hertz Donuts is back in the pack scoring. Pushed to the inside by the captain, Tabrina Schreiner. Pushed again by Tabrina Schreier. At the front, you got Abercrombie contending with, of course, Steffery.
Of course.
No, that is not even Steffery. That is Bangs McCoy, the pivot for Demolition City, making her life miserable, as well as Lickety Splint. Whew, Hertz Donut exits the pack, panting. She picked up a 5-point pass, but it did not look easy. Abercrombie has finally completed her initial pass, and no points after all of that work. Hertz Donut enters the pack, I would say nonchalantly, but I think she's just tired.
3 more points, Patrick.
Yeah.
17 points on that jam. You know, we saw this when Demolition City played Boulder County. Ooh. There were a lot of two-minute jams in that game. It looks like they're stretching it out in the second half once again. 134 for Queen City, 119 for Demolition City. 18 minutes remaining in this game. Jackson Skate, for the love of it. Jackson Skates, AdamWheels.com on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line. Nah, never mind. We're going to have an official timeout. Looks like they're going to check the scoring, make sure that all the I's are dotted, T's are crossed, and points are added up correctly, Patrick.
And we would definitely want to do that. Imagine.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, the games have been so close this weekend, Patrick, that the math matters. Yeah.
Absolutely. But all that has happened in these 13 minutes of that game, I believe, is probably amounting to one full game in, you know, some other occurrences.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there is so much stuff happening on the track. I know, Patrick, you're doing your best to convey all the information, and I'm just watching it stunned as the numbers just fly at me, the penalties, the points. Jam underway, and that is Lebrellian and Sprint and Tarantino on the Fast Girl Skate Jammer line.
That's right. Queen City in the black, Demolition City in the white. And Boat Jammer's out. However, sprinting. Librolian is lead jammer. What a move. She tried to push her out, but she Sprinting Tarantino lands in the penalty box on a forearm. So Librolian is lead jammer, and she's on a power jam.
Sprinting Tarantino not happy with that penalty, but she does have to sit for the full 30 seconds, Patrick.
Librolian makes quick work of that pack. No, not quite. Water falling at the front. The Demolition City blockers do a beautiful job of filling that penalty. Just as I say that, of course, she picks up 5 points. Librolian on a power jam. That's her first five.
Librolian with 49 points so far in this game. She's lead scorer for Queen City.
Oh, yeah. Sprinting Tarantino is out of the box. She comes out like she's on fire. She exits the pack like nobody's business. That was her initial pass. Librolian is still working on that scoring run. Makes quick work. Here we go, a nice juke to the side. Calls it off. She picks up another four. That's 9 point jam for Librolian. Queen City at 143, Demolition City at 120. I'm excited.
Yeah, and why not? It's chaos on the track. Everyone's running all over the place. Points are being put up on the board. People are skating through the notorious IRD penalty box. We have no idea what's going on half the time because there's calls everywhere on the track. And strangely enough, we're going to start this jam 5-on-5. Incinerator 1666 for Queen City. Godzilla number 82 for Demolition City.
Godzilla takes a bit of a step back, as she always does, but Incinerator had no time to waste. She picks up lead jammer status. Godzilla still contending with that big wall of black at the back of the pack. Incinerator already scoring. She picks up the lap point. Somebody falls in front of Incinerator, and she picks up a penalty, and that is a forearm penalty on Incinerator. She's going to sit in the notorious RED penalty box.
That's her fifth trip, Patrick.
Godzilla exits the pack. That's her initial. She's on a power jam. Pack at a dead stop. At the front of the pack are the four Queen City blockers. They are trying their best to open it up for her. She's sitting at the back just waiting for the road to clear up, but it doesn't seem to be happening. Now she gets it, she engages. Number 44. The 54 head huntress with a nice block on Godzilla. Power jam over. Incinerator back in play. She has performed her initial pass. She's scoring. She's pushing at the front. Makes quick work of that pack. She picks up five. Godzilla, oh, on the inside. On the outside, nobody saw her coming. She completes her scoring run. 5 points right there. Incinerator back in the scoring zone. She was lead jammer, but she was sent to the box, so there is no lead jammer. Another two-minute jam, 20 seconds left in this. Another endless jam. Incinerator sent to the back. She is going to engage again. Godzilla also contending with the defense at the front. She is pushed to the outside. She's going to recycle, but there was no pass, no penalty, not a track cut. She picked up 4 points. Incinerator also picked up three more.
So that is a 9-8 jam in the favor of the Dynamite Dolls. 151-129, 14 minutes remaining. Again, you are watching the International 2014 WFDA D2 Playoffs from Kitchener, Waterloo, Ontario, Canada. This is Queen City against Demolition City. Queen City in black, Demolition City in white. On the Fast Girl Skates, Jammerline will be in white. Sprint and Tarantino, number 51 for the Dynamite Dolls, and that's Low Hits Griffin, number 153 for the Lake Effect Furies.
Jam is off. Sprint and Tarantino recycled at the back. She doesn't know which way to go. She has a nice diamond formation holding her back from the Queen City. Lake Effect Furies at the front. Low Hits Griffin is contending with the defense. She's recycled at the back. But look at that. No, she did not pick up a penalty. In fact, as Sprint and Tarantino picks up lead jammer status, she is way in front. Low Hits Griffin not yet cleared the pack. Oh, and a big wide open window on the inside. Sprint and Tarantino picks up 5 points. Low Hits Griffin at the front facing Badonka Donk. Badonka Donk goes to the ground on her Badonka Donk. And and Low Hits Griffin enters the pack. A nice apex jump. She tries for a point, and yes, she gets it. Three more points for Sprint and Tarantino.
140 for Demolition City, 152 for Queen City. Demolition City on a nice run, only down by 12 points with 12 and a half minutes remaining in this game. S1 helmets are rad, Patrick. Get rad. What?
What? Pardon? Quoi?
Quoi? On the Fast Girl Skates, Jammerline is live rolling, number 622 for Queen City, and in the penalty box. No?
No, I think she's just hiding.
Is she hiding?
No, wait a minute. I think they forgot to feel the jammer.
That will not bode well for Demolition City.
Oh, Lord. They forgot to feel the jammer. They pulled the Montreal. Did I just say that? I did.
You totally did.
Librolian is lead jammer. In fact, she is the only jammer on the track. She's pushing at the front. She's not on the power jam. She's in a jammerless jam, shall we say.
A solo jam.
Yeah, a nice two-minute gift from the Demolition City Derby. Oh, boy, and she is entered the pack again. They have four blockers, at least, who are doing a nice job of containing her. They're not going to make it easy on her, but they have split the pack. Two blockers from Demolition City at the back, two in the front. But now number 44, Still Stitches, goes to the notorious RED penalty box. The Librolian continues to score. 5 more points. That's 10 so far on this jammerless jam, solo jam. She's entered the pack. The pack is moving ever so slightly. 7-11. Day Tripper comes in to help her out, and that works so just fine. Librolian picks up 5 more, 15 so far. Queen City at 167, Demolition City at 140. And here we go, an easy pass for Librolian. I'm afraid this is going to hurt Demolition City, a costly mistake.
Yeah, that's a huge mistake, Patrick.
Librolian, oh, tries for the apex.
That's going to end the jam.
No, she does not land it. And how often have we seen this? A one jammer jam, the jammer gets a penalty, and there are no more jammers. History is being made at this first historic Canadian tournament.
Is it a good kind of history, though, Patrick? 174 for Queen City, 140 for Demolition City. Now, 175 on the scoreboard. I'm seeing 174 on my ringster. Updates 23-0 on that solo jam. And now we get a power start for Hertz Donut as Demolition City decides they want a jammer in this jam.
Well, I believe they're going to run a makeup sometime, but they will only get 30 seconds, however. She does have to complete the initial pass, which will be no small task because there are four very abled Queen City blockers, minus one right now. She's going to the penalty box. That's a number for 240. I want to lay her out.
Fifth trip.
Hertz Donut completes the initial pass. Not so fast. Says 7-11 Day Trip her. She's going to land in the penalty box for that dangerous hit.
Yeah, she was about 40 feet out of play.
Yep. And 622 Librarian is back into action. She makes quick work of the initial pass, but Donka Donk heads to the penalty box. Three blockers for Demolition City, two blockers for Queen City. Jam is called off. Queen City now 175, Demolition City 144. 9 minutes left in this period.
Demolition City amazingly not out of this game, even though they had a jam without a jammer. Queen City only able to put up, I mean, they did put up 23 points, but we're going to get an official timeout. Again, another
chaos. I can't see why.
Yeah, I know. This could be, well, we're not going to say why because we will definitely be wrong.
Yep.
When we get back underway on the Fast Girl Skates Jammer line, we'll get number 99, Abercrombie and Fists, and number 82, Godzilla. Again, Godzilla from the Demolition City, Abercrombie and Fists from Queen City. Speaking of the Fast Girl Skates Jammer line, fastgirlskates.com. Fast Girl Skates, 7 years dedicated to making a faster you. They are a sponsor of this broadcast. Patrick.
Yes.
Crazy games all weekend, but this may be the craziest of them all.
Well, I think if we were going to announce one game to choose and to get every single rule possible, I think this is a test.
It is. you are correct. You just have to have people watch this game and try to make all the calls. Double H, you have some clarification for us.
So I think the term you might have used was reckless, because that's exactly the term that the officials used. Black 711, Day Tripper, has been expelled for reckless blocking out of play.
And that, I don't have, I mean, who cares if I have a problem with that or not, but she was well out of the zone of engagement. She was 30 to 40 feet in front of that pack, and she continued to chase after the jammer. You can't have that,
well,
especially
no.
not
Plus
at this level.
She crashed. She practically crashed into the Queen City bench, into her own bench. Yeah. We like to play rough, but we like to play safe.
Exactly, Patrick.
Yep. Yep, we just saw her exiting the track. Somebody's going to have to sit in the penalty box for her penalty.
They
That's number
indeed.
60, Pepper Sticks from Queen City.
Queen City still with lots of penalty trouble. Again, Incinerator with 5 trips. I want to lay you out with 5 trips. Shrier and Headhuntress, Pepper Sticks, Librarian. Day Tripper had 4 trips, but she has been expelled from this game. But tons of penalty trouble on the Queen City side. Shelby in Pain and Stefferie. Both at 6 for Demolition City. They have to be careful. Again, we're going to get Godzilla against Abercrombie and Fist. 175, 140. Queen City in lead. Queen City in black. Demolition City in white. And that whistle, rolling whistle, indicates we're almost going to get Derby back underway, Patrick, with 8 minutes and 48 seconds. If you think this game is crazy, please let us know on Twitter at hashtag #talk2the2 WFTDA.
Can you believe there's 8 minutes left in this game?
No.
I feel like we've been at it all afternoon. Abercrombie and Fist facing Godzilla. Queen City 175, Demolition City 144. Abercrombie is at the front and making a break for it. She's got one more blocker to face, and she makes quick move it. That was 9-1-1 for Alarm Felon. She picks up lead jammer status, and she is in no hurry to enter the pack, as the pack is practically not moving. Godzilla having a hell of a time trying to complete her initial pass. It's not happening. The blockers for Queen City are all at the back, making it very difficult on her. There goes Pepper Sticks, pushing her out. Abercrombie coming in for another scoring run. She gets the jammer lap point. She's at the front. Of course, Pepper Sticks is stretching that pack way, way, way at the back. Boat jammers having a hard time, but Abercrombie having a harder time because she is sent to the penalty box on a back block.
A star pass into pack, Patrick, number 22, Bangs McCoy. She is now the jammer of record. 15th jammer penalty for Queen City.
Whew. Bangs McCoy has to complete the initial pass. She didn't even have to put on the cap. I would have left it off to just spread confusion. But in any case, number 22, Bangs McCoy, is now the jammer for Queen City. Demolition City. The jammer for Queen City is in the box. And she makes quick work of that scoring run. Bangs McCoy picks up 5. The pack at a dead stop. 4 blockers for Demolition City, 3 for Queen City. She hits the pack, falls to the ground. And then she squeezes her head in between 2 blockers. Number 4, 240, Ivana lay her out, tries to lay her out. But she stays on her skates. Power Jam over Abercrombie and Fist is back in play. Jam is over, three more points for Abercrombie and Fist, and none for Bangs McCoy.
Again, 8-5 Jam in favor of Queen City. 183-149 is the score. Queen City in the lead. It's actually 16 jammer penalties for Queen City at the moment. 10 for the Dynamite Dolls. 26 jammer penalties in this game. That is 13 minutes of penalty time in a 60-minute game. That's a lot of penalties.
Number 622 jamming for Queen City. Librolian, Sprinton Tarantino is in for Demolition City. Librolian makes a break for, actually Sprinton Tarantino makes a break for it and picks up lead jammer status. Librolian's at the front. Look at that stride. She is going after Sprinton Tarantino. Sprinton Tarantino has control. Demolition playing minus two blockers. Queen City minus one blocker. Sprinton Tarantino enters the pack. Swings her hips around the hips. Picks up 3 points and none for Librolian. I almost thought she had it.
Demolition City now at 157 to Queen City's 183. They crawl a little bit closer with 5.5 minutes remaining in this game. Want a game-changing experience? Check out Pilot Plates and Vertigo Boots at AdamWheels.com. You have to wonder who's going to be the game changer in this game. On the fast girl skates, Jammerline 153, low hits Griffin 44, steel stitches for Demolition City.
Well, both very active players in this, not only in this half, but in this entire bout. There's been a dance of jammers for both sides. Now, both jammers having a hard time breaking through the pack. It seems like Steel Stitches is going to be the one. A last attempt by Pepper Sticks, but Steel Stitches remains on her skates. She picks up lead jammer status. Low hits, clears the pack as well for Queen City. Entering the pack first is Steel Stitches. She makes quick work of it. She doesn't even bother to clear the pack. She picked up two and called off the jam as she saw Low Hits Griffin was approaching the pack.
Little bit at a time, Demolition City crawling back in this game, 183 to 159, 24 points separating these teams with 4.5 minutes remaining in the game. They're going to have to get more than 2 points for Jam if they're going to want to get the lead. They want to have a chance to play against DC. Guillotine is in the middle. I believe he's going to call a timeout. There he goes.
Yeah.
Eddie now wants an official review.
He wants a review.
Not a bad official review if he has something that he really wants to say. They still have three timeouts. Lots of time to stop the clock if Queen City wants to stop the clock. 4 minutes and 18 seconds remaining in this game. If he saw something that he... I mean, he managed to get an extra penalty called on Demolition City at the end of the first half. So he's been very successful. He is a former referee, does know the rules well. He does get worked up on the bench from time to time. But again, this game has been somewhat chaotic. And having worked a bench myself every once in a while, I understand how that gets.
Oh, absolutely. We've been working ourselves up. So if you are not worked up, I don't know what's wrong with your pulse.
If there's something wrong with your pulse and you wish to tell us about it, please hashtag talk to the WFTDA. Talk to WFTDA on the Twitters. Again, I am Captain Lou Obamo. This is Plastic Patrick. You are watching International 2014 WFTDA D2 Playoffs from Kitchener-Waterloo in Ontario, Canada. It's Queen City versus Demolition City. Queen City coming in the 2 seed, Demolition City the 8 seed. They are playing for the opportunity to play for 5th place against DC tomorrow at 2 o'clock. If you lose, you will end up playing for 7th place against the Outfit at noon. Everybody wants to finish as high as they possibly can. Queen City already going to finish lower than when they came in, but
well,
they can salvage some.
Absolutely. I mean, these games will count for next year's rankings.
Yes.
So, you know, you don't want to give up because they count more than regular season games. Still, a full day tomorrow.
Full day.
Full day tomorrow. All of these teams will have one bout. Tomorrow's a little bit of a shorter day, 5 games instead of 6. However, you will have the championship game at the end of the day, which will feature Bear City and the winner of
the next game, Patrick, you're right. Sorry.
And the winner of the next game, which will be Rideau Valley or Gold Coast.
I suspect there will be a fan or two sitting by their computer watching that on WFTDA.tv. We also have Division One playoffs coming up in September. You can get your viewing pass for just $12. The D2s were 7. A little bit more for D1, but I got to tell you, if the D1s can match the D2 action that we have seen in Duluth and Kitchener-Waterloo, that will be money well spent.
Yeah, and it all gets started in Sacramento, hosted by the Sacred City Derby Girls on September 5th to 7th. Double H, you've got some crack info for us.
So Queen City challenging another no-call on a clockwise block, and this time the no-call stands.
There you go. That is the official review used by Queen City. They're still up by 24 points, Patrick. They are going to send number 622, Librarian, to the Fast Girl Skates Jammer line. Librarian with only a 46% lead jammer percentage. That is the best on the Queen City side. She does have 76 points. On the other side, Demolition City in white is going to send Sprint and Tarantino. She has jammed 11 jams, 36% lead jammer percentage, 22 points. Notorious R.E.D. penalty box is clear, surprisingly.
Whew. Party.
So let's see what happens. 4 minutes, 18 seconds to go, Patrick.
Queen City 183, Demolition City 159, and the jam is off. At the front, we have Demolition City. Demolition City contending with Librarian. At the back, we have Recycling Sprint and Tarantino. She makes a break for it, but at the front is, there goes again, number 25. Lickety Splint, Recycling, Librarian at the front. Ooh, at the front, everyone is staring down on Sprint and Tarantino as she falls to the ground. She picks up lead jammer status, number 82, last line of defense. Tuesday Hula was too far and had to let her go. Librarian is making a break for it to complete her initial pass, number 82 again. Tuesday Hula, incredible. Oh, big hit by Steffery on Librarian to Recycle her at the very back. Sprint and Tarantino, in the meantime, is on a scoring run. She's entered the back. She's pushed to the ground, and I hate to say this, but I secretly love when jammers call the jam off from the ground.
Flat on their back. Another five-point pass. Now Demolition City at 164. 183 for Queen City. They remain there. 19 points separating these teams. 3 minutes remaining in the game. It is Low Hits Griffin, number 153, taking the star for Queen City. Number 44, Steel Stitches, in white for Demolition City. On the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, and we get the jam underway.
Yep. Have you noticed the jammer rotation has drastically changed for both teams?
Yes.
Steel Stitches, a very active jammer in the second half. As a matter of fact, she's contending with the big wall of black at the back of the pack. In the front, Low Hits Griffin picks up lead jammer status. She is the jammer in charge. Low Hits Steel Stitches still contending with the Queen City defense. Quick work. Low Hits Griffin is already scoring. Recycled at the back of Steel Stitches. Also is Low Hits Griffin. Recycling. How modern of them. Oh, big hit on Steel Stitches. She goes out, but so does the blocker, number 240, Ivana, lay her out. So she gets out, and that was her initial pass. 5 points are awarded to Low Hits Griffin. She calls it off as she is milking the clock, of course. Good work for Low Hits Griffin.
Yeah, I believe that was Pepper Sticks with that monster hit, slowing up Steel Stitches. A timeout by Demolition City. Very smart move as time is ticking down this game. 1 minute and 58 seconds remain. 188 for Queen City, 166 for Demolition City. 24 points separating these teams. There is still one timeout left for Demolition City, one official review left for Demolition City. Demolition City needs to put some points up on the board, Patrick.
Yeah.
They've got to claw it back in the last minute and 58 seconds. Queen City, if they get lead jammer, they could potentially kill the entire game clock.
Yeah, absolutely. This wouldn't be the first two-minute jam of this bout. Do we find it interesting that Queen City has not used one timeout yet? You know, you want to keep them for the end of the game. But with all of those two-minute jams, Queen City has not used one timeout. They have used, however, both official reviews. In the first half, they were right. And in the second half, they were wrong.
On the Twitters, Darius Sarah Curran is loving all the insane, intense, great games. I am too. Susie Powell says, why does everybody keep hitting each other? It's roller derby, Susie. Carla Tilt's brain is exploding. Susie Powell wants to know, who has the most jammer penalties? Susie Powell, it is Queen City with about a million right now, or 16.
Sprint and Tarantino for Demolition City. Librarian again out for Queen City. Librarian out on the track cut. So this is a power jam that Britton Tarantino has been waiting for. This is the moment where Demolition City can crawl back into this game. They're sitting at 164, Queen City 188.
Yeah, they're going to want to manage the clock properly, but big opportunity, Patrick. 5 points right there.
Very easy pass for Britton Tarantino. Now 169, 188. She's coming in for another scoring pass. Two blockers only out there for Queen City. This is a big opportunity for Demolition. She's pushing that pack. Number 46 is the last line of defense. She put her foot out, and she picked up a track cut. Britton Tarantino, not what the way that she wanted to end this jam. Librolian comes back into play. Power jam over for Tarantino, but has started for Librolian.
It's going to be the last jam, Patrick.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. 50 seconds left. Queen City pouring it on. Librolian pushed to the ground. She has to complete her, she does have to complete her initial pass. So she's doing all of this work for no points.
No points, but potentially the win, Patrick.
Yep. Well, absolutely the win. You know, she could just stay back and not.
What kind of madness are you speaking
of?
Oh,
Lord. And not engage, because she could potentially score, get another jammer penalty. But she's, looks like she's, no, she's slowing it down. She's slowing it down. Britton Tarantino is going to engage, however. She has nothing to lose. And right she should. She's making quick work of that pack.
Librolian,
a jammer penalty
pack.
On Librolian. 5 points. Five more points for Britton Tarantino. Oh.
Britton Tarantino also picking up a track cut at the end of that jam. Absolute chaos as the game ends. Queen City is going to win, as we had two jammer penalties aside. Because, you know, why not have more jammer penalties at the end of the game? I believe that works out to 18 jammer penalties for Queen City. On the Dynamite Doll side, I believe it is 12, unless they did not account for Britton Tarantino's extra one, in which case it's 13. That would make 30 jammer penalties, or 31 jammer penalties. Oh, there it is. Yes, 31 jammer penalties in this game. The unofficial final is 188 to 174. That final jam, Patrick, was a 10-point jam for the Dynamite Dolls. But that's it. That's the final. Queen City coming away with a very interesting victory.
Well, you know, after the game is wrapped up, as far as we're concerned, a victory is a victory.
Absolutely.
However, you know that they're going to go back to the meeting room and have a discussion about penalties.
Yeah. Steffery fouling out on the last jam of the game, giving her all for Demolition City. Fantastic game on the key blocker. Did a great job all game long. Managed to stay in until the final jam of that game. Penalties abounding. Top scorer for Dynamite Dolls was Hertz Donut with 40, Librolian with 76. But the story of this game is Queen City winning, even though they committed 18 jammer penalties.
Well,
that's a lot.
At the end of the day, the game is theirs, and they get to move on. They will be playing for fifth place. Demolition City will be playing for seventh place. That's all going down tomorrow. Coming up next, a very important game will decide who goes on to the championship bout of the weekend and who goes on to play for number three, who goes to play for Nashville.
That's right. If you win this game, you get to go to Nashville.
Absolutely. And who would not want to go to Nashville? Y'all. Gold Coast certainly wants to. Rideau Valley certainly wants to.
Yes, they do. Again, I am Captain Lou Albamo here with Plastic Patrick. You have been watching the Division II playoffs from Kitchener-Waterloo, Ontario, brought to you by Tri-City Roller Derby and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. This was Queen City versus Demolition City, and the final score, 188 to 174. Queen City winning. Queen City moving on to play for fifth place with DC. Demolition City playing for seventh place against the Outfit. Fantastic game, Patrick. Lovely to work with you as always.
As always.
That's bye it, folks. Bye. We'll see you in a bit.
Yeah. say we don't do enough. We don't stock enough skates, especially the bargain basement variety. We don't carry in lines or know the best place to get them. We don't have every package from every manufacturer. They say all these things. Yet every day, we measure your feet. We study your stance and tailor your fit. We mount your plates and answer your questions. We build skates that make you fly. We're not here for them. We're here for you. And we want to make you go really, really fast. Make them catch up. Visit us online at fastgirlskates.com.
You're watching WFDDA.TV.